The H3000 Band Delays Mark II is a fully refreshed version of the 8-voice, fully parametric, tempo-based filtered delay plugin from Eventide, and it boasts over 100 presets, including all the old ones, plus a variety of new ones. Now, we have soft keys at the top, and they let you customize the preset parameters. So we click on one of these and then move this, and it'll adjust, in this case, delay. I can click there and adjust the feedback. Or we can simply click on these values and mouse slide them. Each preset can contain up to 16 snapshots where we can load, save, and even automate different variations or scenes of these settings. So let's say I like this variation that I just set up. I can command click, for example, on 2, give it a name optionally if I want, and then I can click here to toggle between the different settings. And when we're in global mode, we have 16 separate settings that are independent of the preset that's called up. And here we get the 16 variations per preset. Now here we have global settings. We can sync this to the DAW tempo and meter, or when this is off, we can set it manually. And delay sync allows the delay times to be calculated based on the tempo parameter and the meter parameter. And we can offset it if we want. And when it's grayed out like this, it means it's being modulated. And in this case, we can see that it's being modulated by this soft key. So when I move that, it's adjusting the value. Now, this master frequency control affects all 8 filter frequency parameters. It acts as a kind of offset parameter, meaning that the frequency value here is added to the individual frequency values of each of the up to 8 delays. And the master Q control, which we can see is controlled with this soft key, adjusts the resonant peak right at the cutoff point. And then we have a global pan offset. And feedback delay is the parameter that determines the length or delay time of the feedback loop. So it can be set here with this fader, but we can also get to it in the beat grid, which we're going to look at in a moment for quantized offsets. So this delay is independent of the 8 filtered delays, so it's great for repeating sections of audio through the multi-tap delay line. And then the feedback control, of course, is the amount of feedback that is fed back into the signal. Now, we have a mix control here, and related to this, we have a mix lock. So if you're auditioning presets, you can lock your value. And then we have input and output gains, and here we can meter the input and output info. Now, to get to the 8 individual parameters, we can click the program button here to open up this advanced section, or we can use this expand button. So we have 3 pages, program, expert, and function, which we can get to from here or from here. So here we have the 8 delays. We can turn each one on or off independently, and we drag this in the beat grid to get the 16th note offsets. And then this is the feedback delay control, which we can move in quantized increments rather than move freely from the global section. So we can invert the phase for each of these taps. We can set the filter frequency, and we have a nice display of it here. We even see the pitch of it, so we can adjust that or quantize it to a specific pitch if we adjust it there. And then we have resonant peak if we want it sharp or more coarser, and even different filter types. Here we set the delay amounts independently, or here it's with quantized movements. And then we have an output level for each tap and panning, and these are mirrored for each of the 8. Now, in the expert view, it's a different way of viewing the same information where we turn each on or off, invert the phase, set the frequency, and so on. And here we can adjust the delay time more clinically to an exact value if you want. And then we have the panning and so on. Now, the function page is where it gets interesting. And here's where we assign the soft keys and what they're going to control and other potential modulation. So these are the modulatable parameters. And if we click here, we see the available options. We have the soft keys, variety of MIDI controls, or the internal function generator, which we get to over here, which is kind of like an internal LFO, which we can use. So we set the modulation routing here, and we have minimum and maximum values that we can set. So they don't necessarily need to go to the full range. For example, this global delay, if I dial this now, it won't go all the way up based on the maximum value. Now here for each soft key, we can give it a custom name if we want, and we can optionally toggle the displayed range from negative 100 to 100, which is useful for things like frequency range that go from negative to positive values. And the internal LFO can be a variety of shapes. We can set the speed and the amplitude of it and optionally have it either synced to tempo, or we can manually trigger it and we can set the trigger to one of these MIDI controls. Let's hear it in action. Here I've got a default preset, and this is the bass sound I'm working with. Let's see if we can make it more interesting. I'm going to start by programming some delays. I'm going to leave the first one alone. I'll put this one maybe at the 4th 16th note, then this one the 3rd, and this one the next downbeat. And the rest I'm going to leave off. I'm only going to use 4 for now. And I'll leave these frequencies as is. And maybe the 4th one I'm going to change to low pass. And let's hear where we're at to start with. Okay, that's sounding nice, and I'm liking the low pass at the end. I'll do a nice big resonant boost there as much as I can. And I'm going to maybe pan some of these. Let's pan that one, and this one. I'll go all the way to the other end. And now let's set up some modulation to add more movement and really get it interesting. So the global frequency offset, I'm going to set that to the function generator. And here you can see it oscillating already in a straight sine wave kind of motion based on this speed. And maybe I'll change this to random. And you can see the movement changing here. And I'm going to modulate the rate as well. But let's leave it like that for now. And already we'll be able to hear a difference. That's great. Let's add some more modulation. The feedback delay, I'm going to assign that to the function generator as well. And now we can see that moving. But let's narrow the range a little bit. I don't want it to quite be as wild. Maybe I don't want to have it go down quite as low. So something like that. And let's assign the feedback as well to this so we can get different amounts fed back in. And again, that's moving now, but I'll change the minimum and maximum values so that they're going to be working in different amounts and we'll get a constantly varying amount of feedback. And finally, let's modulate the rate itself with the function generator. Let's tame the movement, and we can use the minimum and maximum fields to get either slower variations or faster variations. So that's the H3000 band delays Mark II from Eventide.